Hey VC, it's Chad. So it's been almost a month since I've done my last haul video. So these are some of my vinyl finds from March. And I have a few different formats here. So let's get started. The first thing here was something that I wanted for a very long time. And I had talked about, I just picked up the kind of the best of 2LP that they have done on Runout Groove. And I saw this on eBay and I made an offer. And, it makes noise. The guy accepted it and I bought it right away. And it's the complete Funhouse Sessions from the Stooges. So this is the unnumbered edition, 7 disc set on CD, and really awesome. I've been just taking like one disc at a time into my car and listening to it for a while, so I'm familiar with pretty much everything on here. It's the Stooges, one of the best albums, if not the best album of all times. Funhouse Complete Sessions. I have a few 7 inches here. One I got as a gift, and it's a free flexi Monster Adventures in Outer Space. This was a serial premium that you got on, I think, a box of like Count Chocula, Booberry, or Frankenberry. It's really clean. I haven't played this, but you can listen to it online or whatever. So I collect Monster Serial stuff, so this is super cool. So Half Price Books had a sale last week, coupon week, so found some good stuff. I found this 7-inch. I don't think I even used a coupon. Was fairly a couple bucks, so it's the Parliaments, and this is I Want to Testify on the back with I Can Feel the Ice Melting. So the Parliaments with George Clinton, this is some of his earliest work, and the labels are super trippy, so I was happy to pick this up. It's surprisingly, it looks pretty bad, but it sounds really awesome, so I was happy to pick this up. And here's just a cassette I found for, I think, like 90 cents or something. This is my favorite Aussie record, No More Tears. And this is almost mint, looks like mint condition, so I have this on vinyl as well. And CD, so I didn't have the cassette, No More Tears. All right, so one thing I just got today that I listened to, it's a soundtrack for a movie that I don't know if a lot of people have seen it yet, but it's the Polka King on Netflix starring Jack Black. And this is the soundtrack put out by Lakeshore Records. And what they had done was offered maybe a really small edition, like 50 or something online. And they were all signed by Jack Black. So I picked that up real quick. I'm from Pennsylvania, so I'm not a stranger to polka. Even the Pennsylvania polka's on here. I watched the movie the other night. It's entertaining. The story about Yan Luan and the fraud and whatnot he committed is pretty crazy. There's a documentary on Netflix as well. It's just called The Polka King. It's really interesting. Check it out. So this is the soundtrack. This wasn't any more expensive than, you know, the regular edition, so I picked this up and it sold out fairly quickly. fun polka music by Jack Black, which, you know, I enjoy some of his work, so I was happy to pick this up. So here was a compilation that I picked up that was really cheap. It's Zapped. This is like a second pressing, I believe, on Reprise. This is basically a compilation of Frank Zappa's label Bizarre, and it has Captain Beefheart, Alice Cooper, Wildman Fisher, Tim Buckley, Lord Buckley, Mothers of Invention. Nothing that's, it's all just, you know, cuts from some of the albums that are on Bizarre, like, and straight from around 1970 or so. And the first edition had Frank Zappa on the cover. This is kind of like a collage, so definitely pick this up. It was super cheap. Speaking of Captain Beefheart, I found this The Lost Broadcast. This is a LP that's issued on Let Them Eat vinyl out of the UK, I believe. And this came out in 2013. So I found a used copy of this. It's a little nice gatefold. The vinyl's nice and heavy. I'm not sure if this was released on anything else, but these are just kind of like alternate tracks from like a live show. The quality is really great. It's got three versions of I'm Gonna Burglarize You Baby on it, and some other stuff that's interesting, so it's pretty fun. Captain Beefheart. We'll skip this one. So, I think I've talked about The Clash several times, and this was a record I didn't have on any format, and it is Cut the Crap. So this was The Clash's last LP from 1985. Mick Jones had already left, and someone came in to, you know, kind of finish the record, so it's kind of all over the place. Most people talk about like We Are the Clash and This Is England, but this record is kind of a miss for me. So, but I'll revisit again, see if I can find something useful in it. But otherwise, it is crap. So here was a record I've shown on Facebook group. This was a grail for me. I've been looking for several years for a copy, and I finally got a nice copy. The vinyl is like VG Plus, so I can probably upgrade it, but I'm happy with this for now. And it's the Games, Dames, and Guitar Things from guitarist Eddie Hazel. And this is a promo copy, and I think it's the Los Angeles or pressing, so it sounds really great. A couple noise crackles here and there, but not too bad. It covers in great shape. It's got the original inner sleeve, so really happy to have this. So here was a record I found. I'm not a huge fan of live records, but I saw Vinyl Richie, I believe it was showing a few records from him, and it's Lou Reed, and this is Lou Reed Live. It says previously released as AFL1. I don't know if it had the same name, but this is in like a Best Buy series on RCA. It's kind of almost, it's not Dynaflex, but it's really flimsy. This came out in 1975. It's got Walk on the Wild Side, Vicious, Sad Song. So not a lot of hits, but it's really great live. It sounds great. So Lou Reed's great. There's a record. I honestly don't remember if I showed this last month, but I don't remember exactly when I got it. Was sometime between this and the last video. I was really, really happy to pick this up. I've shown a few little records from this guy before, and it's a blues theme from David Allen and the Arrows, and I love his death stare on the cover. And this is a super nice, clean copy on Tower Records. This is actually a stereo copy, and it says Duophonic on the labels. There's a couple different pressings of this, but really great fuzzed out guitar, like surf or like biker inspired music. So David Allen. Here's a band I used to listen to when I was younger, and I've kind of lost my way with them. I kind of can take them or leave them. I don't know really why I've kind of grown apart from them, but maybe just because I'm older. But I picked this up. I really dig this. It's the Dead Kennedys and God We Trust. I used to have this on cassette. Didn't have a vinyl copy. Actually don't have all the Dead Kennedys records. I have Fresh Fruit and Original, and I have a couple LPs, and then I have original cassettes. But, you know, I get in the mood to listen to them sometimes, but most of the time I'm kind of annoyed by some of the songs. But this is a really great EP, so, and it's an original, so, In God We Trust. So what I'm listening to now is a pickup that I got on, this is an original Impulse, well, actually not original. It is an original, but it's a red label, and it's Pharoah Sanders, Jewels of Thought. And this is a nice gatefold record, free jazz, kind of. Been trying to get into as much Pharoah Sanders as I can. I think this is the second or third record I've found in the last 3 months or so. So here is a one I wasn't familiar with. I picked up based on the name. Haven't really spun it very much, but it's a private press record, kind of like jazz rock, or it has lots of horns and rock. Kind of hard to describe, but it's Bigfoot, the self-titled record from Bigfoot, and this is on Wine Row Records. Came out in the late 60s, I believe. I think they're out of California. And I don't really know too much about the band. I couldn't really find anything online. So it's got a trippy cover, but it's not that psychedelic as far as I remember. But it was really cheap, so I picked it up. Bigfoot. I've been showing a good bit of stuff from this guy, and I was happy to pick this one up. It's Love Man from Otis Redding, and this is a promo copy, a white label on Atco. And I didn't have this record, so definitely wanted to add it to my collection. Love Man is a great track, and I don't think anything else on here was a like on any greatest hits or anything, but Love Man, everybody should know. Here's a record I wasn't really familiar with, but a lot of people talk about him, and it's the self-titled or first record from John Prine. This is actually a pretty expensive record. It's been reissued, but I found this original in a bin, and it's kind of like VG, and there's some ring wear on the cover. It plays okay, so I picked it up just to check it out. It's pretty good, like, you know, country. So I lucked out a couple last week, I think it was, and found a couple records from this artist that I've been getting more into. Had a few other records from him. And this is Tom Waits, and it's Blue Valentine. And the thing about this record is I won't pull it out, but whoever bought this originally, you know, they wrote in on the inside what, you know, where they bought it, the date, and then on the actual original inner sleeve, they wrote this huge, kind of like a diary, that they were talking about they were professing their love for Bette Midler, and how they believe that this Blue Valentine is kind of a nod to Bette Midler. It's kind of wacky in a way, but there's lots of newspaper clippings for reviews and stuff that were pasted on it, and found some other cool stuff. There was actually an original ad, like a movie ad for the Warriors, was inside as well, so that was cool to find from 1979, I believe. So this is an original pressing on Asylum, and was happy to pick that up. And then this was the other Tom Waits that I found, and it's Nighthawks at the Diner. This is another original one, Asylum Records. The vinyl's pretty clean here, but there's some significant ring wear on the LP, on the gatefold jacket. But I didn't have this record, so I picked it up, and it's pretty good. This is a, I'm trying to think of the, I can't think of, couple, it's a coupled record, so, you know, there's side one and side four, side two and side three, so, I've been listening to it just like side one, then side four, because I, you know, I have to manually turn them over and whatnot. So I don't know if that's the best way to do it, but I don't have a auto couple or automatic machine. So Tom Waits. So here was a newer record that I bought online. This one sold out really quickly from the website, and this is a bit of 80s nostalgia for me. It's the original soundtrack for the Transformers animation show from the 80s, and this was an exclusive on Think Geek, and it's a Bumblebee variant on yellow and black. I wasn't really blown away by the soundtrack. The actual theme sounds a little different than the original, maybe. And then the music's okay. I have a Japanese version of the Japanese series that was actually, it's much more interesting. The cover's, you know, a little cooler. There's an Obi strip. But I'm glad I picked this up. There are almost 40, there are 40 tracks on here, so some of them are quite short, and it's only a single LP. It's a gatefold. There's some art inside and whatnot, so Transformers. So this one seemed like so long ago that I bought these that I have a few copies. This is one of my favorite records, but I bought these at a local store because of the stickers, and it's these Smile Price stickers. These are kind of, I think these are from Germany. This is a record on Cube Records. But, you know, obviously, this is the Electric Warrior from T-Rex. And this is one of my favorite records of all times. So, this is not a gatefold, it's just a single jacket. I think this came out in the early to maybe like 84 or 85, I forget. I looked them up, but I thought these little stickers were pretty cool. So, Smile Price. So I got Electric Warrior, and I picked up the Tanks record as well. This one is on Teldec. It's also out of Germany, but I don't know if these stickers, if anybody knows anything about these Smile Price stickers. I'm assuming it might be related to an actual store rather than the pressing itself, but if you know anything about them, leave a comment below. And I have originals. I have a nice original of this Tanks record with an original poster already. I have several copies of Electric Warrior with, I have a white label promo and an original gatefold on reprise as well. So, T-Rex. So a couple more here. Found some weird foreign pressings. And the first one I have here is Sin After Sin from Judas Priest. And this is an original pressing on CBS. This came out in 1977. And this is from it's made in Holland, so I guess it's a Dutch pressing. But it's got I don't know if you're familiar with, obviously, Judas Priest, but this is an early record. A lot of people, fans prefer this is more hard rock, and people are really into the metal stuff, but it's got it's an odd choice. It's got a cover of Diamonds and Rust. It's a cover of Joan Baez. And the song on here, Sinner, is amazing. But I really like this record, actually, so I'm not sure. Sin After Sin. And then I found this pretty sweet compilation called Hero Hero. And this is an original on Gall Records. And this is actually, I don't think it has, it might be missing one or two tracks, but this takes tracks from their first two records, or maybe the three, I forget. Rock and Rolla and Sad Wings of Destiny. I don't know if it has stuff from Sin After Sin, I forget. Yes, because it has Diamonds and Rust on it. So this is a gatefold compilation. I think there's a US pressing of this anyways, but this is a German copy on Gall. So it's got pretty cool labels. And my last record here is probably my best find in a while. And I've been listening to this a good bit over the last month or so. It's Teenage Jesus and the Jerks. And this is an original pressing on Migraine Records. The cool thing about this one is that it's on pink vinyl. And it actually really matches the cover. If you're not familiar with Teenage Jesus and the Jerks, this is kind of like early no wave, I guess. It was kind of lashing out against the punk scene. I think it's punk, but it's got Lydia Lunch was the vocalist and guitar. This one is, you know, really noisy, almost like not necessarily, I don't want to say Riot Girl, but some of that sound definitely takes some influence from this record and Lydia Lunch. But the whole first side is really great. Just, I mean, it's not for everybody. It's, you know, I mean, it's really noisy. It's kind of droney and just shrieky. It's no wave, so check it out. I really like the cover art for this. It's really great. And this is out of New York, so T Teenage Jesus and the Jerks is my last find here. So that's all I got for you. I hope you like something here. And I'll be back soon with another haul video. So thanks.